Welcome to Short Planetary Geological Essays, narrated by Daniel Hutchinson. Back in 2015, after the New Horizons space probe passed the planet Pluto, the space probe entered what is known as the Kuiper Belt. The Kuiper Belt is a belt of asteroid-like objects being so far from Earth that the region is uncharted and unexplored. Before the New Horizons space probe was even launched, the Hubble Space Telescope was being used to chart a path beyond Pluto for the Horizons space probe in order to come close to an object 22 miles in diameter known as Arrokoth. It was to be photographed and studied. 3 years after the Pluto flyby, the New Horizons space probe began its approach to Arrokoth. As New Horizons got closer, the images coming in from its camera displayed a strangely shaped object, a crater-free object shaped like two potatoes, one larger than the other, attached to one another. At 2,200 miles from Arrokoth and over 4 billion miles from Earth, New Horizons began its study of this strange-looking Kuiper Belt object. One of the first things noticeable about Arrokoth, besides its strange shape, was its red color. Other asteroids closer to Earth within the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter are a dark gray color. Arrokoth's red color is due to what are called tholins. Tholins are organic compounds that have been broken down by solar and cosmic rays. These tholins on Arrokoth's surface are composed of a combination of methanol, hydrogen cyanide, and water ice. As previously mentioned, Arrokoth's surface is pretty much free of impact craters. This is believed to be because of the Kuiper Belt's smaller objects compared to Arrokoth are situated in a more dispersed pattern around the Sun, and being so far away from the Sun, these objects are much slower in velocity in being able to having a chance in impacting and scarring Arrokoth's surface with craters. The large crater-like feature on the smaller end of Arrokoth is believed to be formed from the release of volatile substances just beneath Arrokoth's surface, producing the large depression. The lack of craters on Arrokoth's surface means that Arrokoth has changed little for billions of years. With there being no to very slow collisions within the Kuiper Belt, it is believed that Arrokoth's shape came to be by two asteroids coming together and fusing with one another at a speed of about 2 meters per second. Two bodies, possibly orbiting one another, and over time slowly getting closer to one another, and then finally becoming what we see today. With both objects being the same color, gives weight that both objects formed in the same region of the Kuiper Belt billions of years ago. New Horizons finally leaves Arrokoth behind, heading deeper into space away from our solar system. It is not known at this time if humans will ever send another space probe to study Arrokoth in greater detail. But we are all fortunate enough to having examined Arrokoth close up thanks to New Horizons.